Good afternoon. Welcome to SCR. You're here with me, Mike Shins, and I'm here with Steve Rowe, one part of the production duo Ancient. How you doing, Steve?
Doing good, thank you.
Good, good, good. So we're here on Solar. What's the day today? It's the 27th of January. It's a new year. And so we got four good shows coming up tonight. First of all, we're starting off with Steve, and Steve's going to be telling us about his new EP. What's the name of the EP?
Godai, Korean for ancient.
Ancient, okay, so Godai. Godai?
Yeah, I think so.
Oh, good, my Korean pronunciation is so good. Okay, so anyway, so we got the Godai EP release. It's a four-track EP. Junsu and I played this on our Nodaji show, one of the tracks last week. And so, what are we starting off with here? Like, this isn't you, is it? Who's this?
Nah, this ain't me. This is Mr. Sister.
So.
This track, we got inspired by it quite a lot because of the percussion work in it.
Okay.
We really wanted some like authentic percussion in our works. Like this kind of stuff. He does like a lot of like African tribal drums.
Okay, so you you have that same sort of sound in your EP?
On some of them, I'll play one tune that's quite inspired by this one. Bradley did a lot of recording himself.
Okay.
At his home with the drums. Bradley's the other half.
So where's Bradley based?
Bradley's based in London.
You're from London, yeah?
No, I'm from Leicester.
You're from Leicester. Okay, yeah. And what are you doing over here?
Teaching English at the moment.
Oh, teaching English. How long for?
I've been here nearly a year now, and then that will be it. Then I'll be off.
When you're done, where's next?
I don't know yet. Maybe London.
Oh, man of mystery.
Yeah, that's it. I don't know where I'll be next.
So this song playing under us right now is Mr. Sister, and it's called, what's it called?
Bala.
Bala, okay, so we're going to leave this one playing. One more time, this is Mr. Sister and Bala. So, like I said, we're talking about the new Ancient EP from Steve here. So tell us about one more. So you're based here at the moment, and yep. Your friend is based in London.
London, yeah.
And so how does that work with the production?
To start off with, it was a nightmare.
Really?
Yeah. Because of like the time difference, well, basically like, before it all began, me and Bradley used to live together.
Okay.
At uni. We did music together at uni.
Mm-hmm.
And we used to live together, and just for like 1 year we lived together, and we just made loads of tunes, just like all day, almost every day. And yeah, we were doing that, but we just didn't release anything.
Mm.
We just were so bad at releasing stuff. When I got to Korea, I decided, right, we'll start releasing things. So we released some old tracks from our older That's our, the first EP we released.
Okay.
Yeah, there were some older tracks that we released. And then we started making new ones. We thought it'd be really easy, just mm-hmm. like before, but it was a nightmare.
Because you're not in the same room, eh?
Not in the same room, not in the same country, not in the same time difference. So, Bradley would send me a track, like some stems, and then I'd like try to work with him, like, what's his idea here?
And then like and then you send him back and he's like, what's he done with this?
Yeah, exactly. Like, just the ideas were all over the shop. So
how long does it take you to play, like, make one track? Because this is a four-track EP, right?
Yeah, this is a four-track EP. So before it used to take us like a day to make a track, because we just spend the whole day, the whole night making music.
Mm.
Now it was taking like 3 weeks to try and get a track down. And the stems, everything was all over the place.
Well, that's dedication. I like it. So
yeah, it was.
Let's go with one. So you said the last track was Mr. Sister, and you said that you were inspired by the percussion on it. So you said the next track, this is one of yours. Can you tell us about this one?
Yeah. So this one is with Ryder Shafiq.
Oh, nice. He was in the studio recently.
Yeah. So he was down in Seoul recently. I knew him through someone else. We had like a mutual friend.
Mm-hmm.
I was like producing an album for a spoken word artist called Moke. That album's took a while to make, over a year and a half. He'll kill me for saying that. we were making an album, and we were using this studio, and Ryder Shafiq happens to use the same studio. So my mate told me that Ryder Shafiq was coming to Seoul and that we should link up, and I went and watched his show. It was really good.
Yeah, it was good, wasn't it?
It was with Aishan Sound.
Mm.
So as soon as he got back to the UK, I sent him a track for some vocals, and he went to the studio and laid this down for us.
And this has got like a similar percussion style to that, like that last track,
in a way. Like, when we get inspired by something, I reckon we just end up going on a completely different path. But it's got like the authentic percussion sounds that Bradley recorded in his home.
Okay.
And yeah, it's just, but it's a lot darker.
Okay, some dark shit. Okay, yeah. So always people from London are pretty dark, or from England. So
that's it, yeah, we can't be happy.
No, it's even if ring. Leicester are winning the title, you still can't be happy.
Yeah, still, because we're not winning anymore. So this one is it's called Mayor.
Mayor? So this is ancient.
Rider. For the right words to describe these strange times, as the world turns, the fire's burnt, oppression is a crime. I'm searching for the answers. How can the blind lead the blind? Too much confusion, disillusion. I'm trying to free my mind, I'm trying to escape the rat race, this fast pace. I'm wasting time in the wrong places. False faces hidden behind fake smiles. Fake your mood, afraid of truth, afraid to heed the signs, afraid to face reality, numb the pain, silence the cries. Question all that you believe in.
Save yourself, put your knowledge, you believe it.
So featuring Ryder Shafiq, that first track there was Maya from the Ancient EP, as we go. So sticking with the dark theme here, the British sound, what are you going to play for us next, Steve?
I'm going to show the dark theme in Japan.
Ah, it's a Japanese dark theme here, so yeah. Not British anymore.
Well, so like Code 9 and the Hyperdub label, I saw Code 9, he went to Japan. And he was with this, it was on a little documentary, I can't remember what it was with, maybe with Native Instruments, I'm okay. Not sure. And he went and played a lot of tunes with this guy, Ina. And they're just, crazy tunes, really dark.
Really?
Not, most of the album isn't that rhythmic either. Ooh. So I've had to choose the most rhythmic for this show.
Because everyone's dancing right now, you know.
Well, yeah, I mean, for everyone dancing back at home. I'll play this one. It's the dark theme that inspired a lot of, like, this one and another track that we made as well. I'll play this one now.
So this is Ina, and what's the name of the track?
Chemically.
Chemically. Sounds nasty. You're listening to SCR. This is the Sol Owl special. JNS is in the building, looking bored, on his phone as always. Typical Korean. getting lazy. We're going to sit down in here, sorry. This is the more rhythmic one, you're telling me.
Yeah, more rhythmic.
So this was Ina from Japan. This track is called Chemically. Another dark track from a dark producer to my left here, Steve.
I promised to brighten things up next.
Okay, so we're going to go bright next time.
Yeah.
So are we going to go with one of your tracks next?
Yeah, I think we'll go with one of my tracks. Okay. So this next one is with a singer from where I went to school.
In Leicester?
In Leicester, yeah, when I was young.
Blue Army.
Me and CJ, we went to school together, and he's doing a lot of music now. He's started up an act for called Magique.
Magique?
Yeah.
How do you pronounce, spell that? Sorry, M-A-J-I-K?
M-A-J-I-Q-U-E. I think it's the French word for magic. Don't quote me on that. I think it is.
You heard it here first.
Yeah.
Magique.
He's doing stuff with, like, I'm sure it's the Foles bass player.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
He's a really good singer and guitarist. So I definitely wanted to get him on the EP. We made this track. It was inspired by the Drive soundtrack.
Oh, nice. Yeah. Okay, this is a little bit different then.
Yeah, hugely different. Oh. That's the thing with this EP. Like, we didn't stick to one genre. We just made what we felt like at the time.
Yeah, that's. I mean, like, do you feel that your taste has changed since coming to Korea?
Oh yeah, definitely. I've been able to have been exposed to a lot more music, and I'm hoping that people back home will realize that Korean music isn't just K-pop.
Yeah, that's. I mean, for people who know about SCR, like, we're really trying to promote the wealth of talent that is here, and there's such good music being made in this country right now. Whether
definitely.
It's like, you know, yes, there's a lot of K-pop, but there's also a lot of good bass music, a lot of good like house music. There's some good producers. There's one of them in the building right here, JNS, although he's lazy and doesn't make enough tracks. if you're new to Korea or if you're new to this scene, like, there's a lot of stuff to check out in this city, and it's a really vibrant space right now. But unfortunately, we're losing one of those producers because Steve is leaving soon. But
yes,
what are we going to play next? What's the name of this next track then?
This one is called Pursuit,
featuring the French Magic.
French Magique.
What's the name of this track?
Pursuit.
Pursuit, sorry. Okay, so this is Pursuit from the Ancient EP by Steve on my left.
Yeah.
So here we have that track was Pursuit. That's a very nice track. I like that one. And what was the guy's name again? Sorry,
Magique.
Magique, the French magician.
Maybe.
Maybe, or possibly not. Okay, so what are we going to go for next?
Maybe something that's kind of similar. Okay, that we'd listen to.
Is this like an inspiration? Maybe.
Yeah. We'll go for an inspiration track. Chromatics.
Chromatics, okay. So tell us about Chromatics.
They were on the Drive soundtrack.
Oh yeah. Which track did they do?
Forgot.
Good question.
They weren't singing on it, though. I remember that.
Okay.
This wasn't a track. Oh, I remember. I can't remember the name of it, but it's like in a 12-minute track.
Oh, yeah, I know the one.
And they've got a 3-minute organ solo where they just play one note for 3 minutes.
Sounds epic.
Yeah. Maybe artsy. I'm not sure. I'm not sure what to call it. This doesn't have any organ solos. We'll just play maybe Lady.
Lady. So this is Chromatics and yes. Lady. Another inspiration for the ancient EP. If I could only call you my lady. Was Chromatics with what's the name of that track?
Lady.
Lady. Okay. So let's play another one of yours next. Let's go with the one that we played on No Dudgy, because I really like that track as well. I mean, I like all of them, obviously. But let's go with that one. Tell us about the vocalist on this track.
Okay, so this vocalist, Tehi, I had some friends that were also teachers, and they had some Korean friends, and my friends knew for the longest time that I was making music, but failed to tell me that they knew two Koreans that owned a studio and made music.
Bloody friends.
And so I would go to the studio and start to use it because space is a little bit limited in a Korean apartment. I've not got too much space for equipment. So I went to this studio. That's when I was like mixing and mastering just my own tunes. But then after a while, I asked Tehi if she would sing on a track. But I wanted it to be, she's fluent in English.
Okay.
But I wanted it to be in Korean. I wanted to work with a Korean artist and have Korean vocals on a track before I left Korea.
Okay, yeah, that's
so nice. That was my goal. So yeah, all the vocals are from Tehi. And
does she have a SoundCloud or anything, do you know?
She works, they've got her and her partner, they have a little duo called Dowdy EQ,
okay,
which is on Bandcamp.
Oh, okay, nice.
And they definitely don't do bass music. It's more like guitar band based kind of things. And it's really good music. So, and it's also kind of like it's got this hip hop vibe as well.
Oh, really?
It's really interesting. Yeah. So that's Dowdy EQ.
And what's the name of the track that you did with her? Sorry.
Chupur.
Chupur,
maybe
again.
Korean for candle. It's actually an interesting story. So obviously everything that's going on with Park Geun-hye, she wanted to do a track about the Korean president and everything that's going on, and the lyrics were inspired by how the Koreans would hold up the candles at the marches, but she wanted to call it Candle in the Wind, which is obviously I
think that's been done before, right?
I had to explain if I called a tune Candle in the Wind, a lot of Elton John fans and the older generation wouldn't be too happy.
I would have quite like that though, I think.
Yeah, just Candle in the Wind. So,
Diana. So here we have a Diana tribute from Ancient.
Yeah, this is it. So we shortened it to Candle.
Well, it's a good compromise. I like
it. Yeah, I think so as well.
So this is a politically charged track.
This is our first political tune.
Getting political here on SCR.
Politics.
Okay. So this is Candle, and the word in Korean is?
Chupul.
Chutbul.
Maybe.
Chutbul, maybe.
Maybe.
This is a fantastic Korean pronunciation. We're going to have confirmation from Lobotomy. Is it Chutbul? Chutbul.
Chutbul.
Chutbul. Chutbul. Thank you, Lobotomy.
So now we just got to work on our French.
Yeah. Okay, so a multilingual show here from the Ancient EP release special. And so this track is Chutbul.
Oh, by the way, Tehi, she's actually calls herself Kaya.
Oh, Kaya.
Sorry, Tehi, if you're watching.
So this is the vocalist is Kaya from Seoul.
Yep.
From Seoul, and this track is called Chutbul. Okay, ready? Keep it locked with SCR tonight. We've got lots of good stuff coming. After this show, we have FPS with Kurd and his special guest Lobotomy. And then later on, we have a very special guest, Jay Boogies, in the show. And then later on, we also have Durio from Singapore. So holiday specials with SCR. Keep it locked. So that was the amazing Chotbu featuring Kaya. That's like the standout track, like the sort of the single you say from the EP, right?
Yeah, we want that to be the main single, which is why it's shorter than all the others.
And so you were mentioning before that you produced a lot of this EP with your friend back home in England, but not all of the tracks, right?
No, so the first two that I played is what I made with Bradley. So he would send me the stems, and then I'd finish off the track. That's how we started to refine it in the end, because it was becoming too hectic. So in the end, he would just send me half of a track with a couple tracks that are inspiration. That's when I got the idea, and then I'd finish it off. But he works at a studio doing music for film, and he's doing something with Massive Attack.
Ooh.
I don't know all the details. So he's doing something with them for a TV show. So he's been really busy at the moment. So it was either the case that I wait till I get back home to finish the EP, which I didn't want to do. I wanted to definitely release an EP in Korea. So the other option was to just finish it off myself.
So so that last track was basically produced by yourself?
Yeah, that's just me on that one.
Okay. And so let's go with something inspirational again. Let's go with these vibes. What are we going to think about next?
I think I'm going to have to go to Burial.
Ooh.
Because Burial is the reason, me too, like Burial's the reason I got into music production. I just never heard anything like it before.
Mm.
I used to do like play guitar in bands.
Right.
And I got fed up of relying on other people. And also I was a terrible guitarist, which is probably the main
reason.
Yeah,
it doesn't help, right?
So I was like, what can I make on my own? And then I remember one of my mates showed me Burial and like other various like dubstep artists from back in the day, like Mellor and Scream and Hatcher. And I was just like, yeah.
And, I mean, it's not like anything else though, Burial, right?
Burial's like just his own.
Completely in a league of his own.
Yeah.
Which I think is why he's such a crossover artist, you know? Like, there's a lot of people who are not into electronic music who like Burial. Like, absolutely. You don't have to be a dubstep fan, or you don't have to be like a bass music fan or something.
No. Nah.
And I mean, he's constantly changing and inspiring, so.
Yeah, I really liked his new stuff as well. I know a lot of people didn't, but Burial's got to... I feel like Burial has to change his sound, because a lot of people are creating sounds just like Burial.
Everyone's trying to do that sort of that weird, like misty vocals that he does.
Yeah, know? So he's got to be the one responsible to push the boundaries.
I like the way he used that. Was it the newest EP where he had the track with the vocals from one of the Wachowski siblings? Or was that the one before?
Oh, I didn't know about that.
I think that was the track before, actually. But anyway, I'm just talking shit now. So anyway, so which Burial track are you going to go for?
I'll play South London Boroughs.
Ooh, beast.
Yeah, this track, like, the best thing about Burial is that something is either added or taken away every two bars.
Mm.
And it's like, can be so subtle.
Yeah.
You got to really listen to it. And every track, every time you listen to it again, you'll realize like it's something new. And this is one of the best standout for me.
Okay, nice. So this is Burial with which track, sorry?
South London Boroughs.
Oh yeah, South London Boroughs. So if you're listening, pay close attention to Burial. Wow, love some Burial. Really do. Okay, so we've got, well, we've got 10 minutes left. What are we going to go for? Are we going to go for one of yours next, or are we going to go for another inspirational track?
Maybe, choices. Maybe I'll play.
Let's play. I'm going to lead this one. I want you to play an inspirational track, and then we're going to finish with a big one from Ancient.
All right. I'll go with.
Pressure. The pressure's on.
I'll play this one. Fortet and Happer.
Oh, okay. Fortet and Happer. I actually listened to this earlier. I love this tune.
Happer. He did this remix when he was 15.
15? How old is he now?
No, probably getting younger. Like 8 now.
Benjamin Button made this track.
Yeah, Benjamin Button. It just, I mean, the kid's like, I discovered Happer when he was doing that 10-minute make a beat in 10-minute thing on YouTube.
The Fact Against the Clock thing.
Yeah, yeah. And he was cutting up little cassette tapes from his dad's collection and just like random tunes and then just like skewering the tape and just making these bizarre and incredible sounds. And then it was like, oh yeah, I'm 18. And I was just like, oh my God.
So if you're older than 18, you've already missed the boat, basically.
Yeah, exactly. And he's already remixing Fortet tunes at 15, so.
Wow. Okay.
Some people.
Some people just do too much. So this is Fortet. It's a Happer remix. What's the name of the track?
Jupiter's maybe. There's a lot of maybes on this show. Yeah, Jupiter's for definite.
Jupiter's for definite. So this is Fortet. It's a Happer remix. We'll be right back. amazing Happa remix of Fortet's track Jupiters, made when he was only 15. I still can't believe that.
Yeah, that's what I read yesterday. I thought maybe it's a typo. I want it to be a typo.
Yeah, he's 25. Okay, so this is our last track. So this has been the Ancient EP release special. Steve has been helping us out with some video work in the studio, and we like the production work that he's been doing as well. So we really wanted to give him and you, sorry, an opportunity here. And so tell us about this last track that we're going to play. We're going to finish on a big one, eh?
Yeah, this one is a dark one again.
Oh.
Yeah. And it's one made by myself. So this one's called Gated. There's not really much else to it. I mean, we were going through the last few tracks and I wasn't happy with one of the tracks that we were going to put on the EP. Mm-hmm. So I scrapped it and then made this instead.
Ooh. So artistic creation right there.
Yeah, I just went crazy and just deleted the whole project. Like, I don't want it anymore, and made this one instead.
Okay, so made after a tantrum.
Definitely.
So this track, one more time, is Gated, right?
Gated, yeah.
So, Steve, thanks for joining us today.
No problem.
Just before he plays this track, this is Gated from the Ancient EP release. If you want to check it out, we'll put a SoundCloud link and everything on our Facebook page. And you can check out Steve and his good work. And when he's left Korea, you can still follow him.
Yes.
So, keep it locked tonight. After us, we have FPS with Lobotomy and Sanghyun, Old Kurd. And then later on, we have Jay Boogie coming in for an hour performance. And then we have also Durio from Singapore. So, last track then, Steve, take it away. Gated.